Hey, I'm Coop with GamerVision.com. I played Shadow of the Colossus then, and here's why you should play it now. Shadow of the Colossus was developed for the PlayStation 2 by the same team that made Ico and is making The Last Guardian. Shadow of the Colossus is one of those games that doesn't have a really deep story but manages to get a lot across either way. The basic plot line follows a character that's not really named but goes by the Wanderer. He travels to this distant forbidden land with a magical sword and has to do some crazy things in order to save the one he loves, who's a fallen princess. I like the game because before I played it, I was watching like movies, like I remember even though I didn't like it, the Final Fantasy VII movie, and they were these huge epic battles where they were fighting giant monsters and like jumping on their back and jumping around, and I was like, why can't gaming do this? And then I played Shadow of the Colossus, and that's exactly what it did. It was more than just like a guy and another guy hitting each other with swords. It was this epic battle. It was almost like a fairy tale. And it was done in such a large scale that I had never seen before. My favorite part of the game is the third Colossus, which is, he has a giant sword, he's referred to as the Knight. And the way you have to beat him is he slams his sword down, and it gets stuck in the ground, and you actually need to run up his sword. And I remember getting to that part, and as he swings it down, I'm like, oh shit, is this what I have to do? I hope this is what I gotta do. And you run up his sword, and he pulls it up, and it's not a cinematic, it's not like a button timing thing. You're in control the entire time. And I was floored. I could not believe that that was able to happen on the PlayStation 2. And the one thing I remember from my first time playing it is you start off and it gives you like a basic tutorial where you're running around and like climbing some ledges and swinging your sword, and I'm like, oh, I'm gonna fight like, I wonder what cool enemies I'll fight, like goblins or ogres or all that kind of stuff. And then you get to the first boss, and the game is just 16 boss battles. There aren't any like little creatures you have to fight. And I got there and I'm like, well, this thing? How am I supposed to fight this thing? It leads you in by making you think it's gonna be a traditional game and then just slaps you in the face and lets you know, like, hey, this is not what you're used to. The game's available on the PlayStation 2 and you can pick it up for that. And if you have the old PS3s, the ones that either had hardware or software emulation, it works on those. And there are some little rumors and speculation that it might be getting a God of War collection treatment, getting bumped to high def, so, you know, fingers crossed on that. Is it a princess? I actually don't know that. I just kind of said that and I probably shouldn't have.